The tests that will be needed before vascular ring surgery include a couple different things. One of the first things that we look at that you have is a CT. A CT will help to confirm the diagnosis of a vascular ring. In some cases, we can also use an MRI. Other testing that we always use in our core group of testing is usually an esophagram. An esophagram is where your child will swallow radiopaque liquid so that we can see exactly where the esophagus lies in relation to the trachea and the great vessels. Some of the other tests that we include, depending on what type of symptoms your child's having, if they have more respiratory symptoms, we'll likely want to get a bronchoscopy. Sometimes we'll do that before the operation, sometimes we'll do that just intraop. If your child has more GI symptoms, such as dysphagia or swallowing difficulties, then we'll likely want to do the modified barium swallow, which takes a look to make sure that your child is not aspirating. One of the most important things is if your child's already had surgery, we want to make sure that both vocal cords are moving well. This is very important for being able to talk and to swallow and not aspirate food. This is where we engage our colleagues from otolaryngology. They will do a bedside test or an in-office test, depending on if you're pre or post-surgery, where a small camera will be passed down the nose and then into the throat area so that we watch the vocal cords move. Your child will not be sedated for this because we want them to be awake so that the vocal cords are seen moving. A bronchoscopy is a test in which your child will have to be sedated. This will include they will go into the operating room and then they will have a scope that is placed down their throat to look at the trachea and then the bronchus. This will help us to evaluate to see how much compression there is and to see if they have a lot of secretions, to see if we also need to do a culture to see if there's any type of respiratory infection while we're there. This can either be done ahead of time if we're very concerned about symptoms or can also be done at the time of the operation. Intraop nerve monitoring is a system which we use to protect the vocal cords. Because the recurrent laryngeal nerve lies so close to the vascular ring structures, we want to make sure to protect this. The way in which we do that for surgery is that we place a small monitoring device, which is like a sticker that goes on the endotracheal tube or the breathing tube when your child's intubated. Once we do this, we then have a probe that when we're in the surgical field, we're able to identify the nerve by touching the nerve, which will then give us a signal showing us exactly where the nerve is. Once we've done this, we're then able to avoid that area as to not cause any vocal cord injury. All testing that is needed for vascular ring surgery can be done ahead of time at Boston Children's. If you're from further away, we will try to consolidate this visit so that you do your testing, and then we can also schedule your operation date. So you'll end up coming to Boston about 5 to 7 days ahead of time. If you want to make it 2 separate trips, if that's easier for your family, we can schedule all of your testing at one time, and then at a later date, we can then schedule your surgery.